Welcome to I'm Your Target Demographic, and today we're discussing the Fermi Paradox, which ultimately asks the big question, where are the aliens? It's named after physicist Enrico Fermi in the early 1900s, who came to believe in this paradox by looking at two facts. One, we've never encountered alien life. And two, there is a high probability of alien life existing. So why is it that we've never encountered them? Fermi started the argument, backed up more recently by another physicist named Michael Hart, who actually researched and published based on the original concept. Here's the breakdown of the argument. In our galaxy, there are billions of stars. Some of these stars, maybe not many, likely have Earth-like planets with the ability to host life of some sort. Some of these would likely have advanced to intelligence and discovered interstellar travel, just like we're working on. Either out of curiosity or necessity, it's likely that some of these planets would begin seeking out other hospitable planets like ours. So now that we have a core understanding of the paradox, let's try to figure out why this is. What could explain the lack of alien contact? In this video, we're going to cover 20 reasons why we haven't seen alien life. Let's roll through them quickly. The first reason is the most obvious. Alien life is rare or non-existent. This is called the rare Earth hypothesis, that Earth is not quote-unquote typical, but in fact one of a kind. There are thousands of factors that all contribute to our planet being hospitable, and that life could even advance to this level. Maybe we are the only one. Maybe no other intelligent life has evolved yet. This assumes that yes, maybe other planets could host life, but maybe that life never evolved, remaining forever in its simple state, like algae or bacteria. Maybe this life did evolve, but they just haven't achieved technology able to communicate or travel. Maybe they're just a few hundred years behind us in advancement, unable to send or receive communications, and unable to leave their planets. We're all living in isolated bubbles. Up next, we have a theory that's a little grim. It's the nature of intelligent life to destroy itself. This theory proposes that with technology comes inevitable destruction, through factors like climate change, resource depletion, or faulty artificial intelligence like a Terminator-like future. This theory also connects to what's called the Great Filter, the line at which civilizations are filtered out. The bigger question is whether we've already passed it and are somehow the greatest example, or if we've yet to hit that point and are just waiting the inevitable downfall. Connected to this theory, what if it's the nature of intelligent life to destroy others? A technologically advanced civilization might understand the threats and concerns of competing races, so might be destroying advanced civilizations as they arise. This could be out of paranoia and fear for themselves, or it could be out of aggression and the simple fact that they can wipe out these civilizations. Now let's get back to more natural reasons, such as extinction events are common. The Earth has endured several extinction-level events, so it's likely that other planets face these same things, constantly destroying or setting back advanced civilizations. Now let's assume that a civilization gets to the point of advanced technology. What if these civilizations are too far apart in space or time? What if millions of years ago a civilization reached this stage and was out there seeking life, while we were just evolving? They went extinct before we had the chance to respond. What if they exist so far away in space that we'll never hear or see them? We might become extinct while waiting for signals to reach that far. Because these civilizations might be so far apart, it leads to the theory that civilizations might lack resources to travel the galaxy. Even if they could travel, to travel across the galaxy might be so cost prohibitive that it's essentially impossible. The energy to propel ships or keep travelers alive, or navigate obstacles. It's why so many science fiction iterations feature ships bound for far, far away lands, and tragedy almost always strikes them. It would cost too much and risk too much to travel. A more simpler reason for not ever experiencing alien life might be that humans have not existed long enough to be noticed. In the timeline of everything we know, the human race is still an infant, a barely noticeable speck. The time that we've been able to send and receive communications is even smaller than that. So the chances of us being encountered or finding communication is just very slim and improbable. Even if we are listening for communication, maybe we are not listening properly. We are looking for communication that looks like ours, in frequencies and metrics that we understand. Maybe we're listening to certain areas of space and neglecting the areas where we might actually find life. We're also assuming that they're sending communication to our general area and in our certain frequencies. Signals might appear to us as background noise and be missed completely. Now, based on our evolution, we can say that radio signals are only viable for a short time. Advanced civilizations will likely outgrow the radio or never use the radio. So they might not be listening for those messages or might be sending messages in another medium, such as somewhere else on the electromagnetic spectrum. We're in such a small window of technology that we might be looking for and sending the wrong type of message. Now again, time for a simpler reason. Advanced civilizations might become isolated. At a certain point of evolution, what if aliens didn't see a reason for communication? Science fiction often showcases artificial environments, and it might be totally realistic for a population to exist in this entirely fictional world, an isolated experience. If all of their needs are met, and they're no longer curious of the galaxy, why continue looking? Even if they were interested, maybe these alien races are actually too alien. In terms of physiology, they might be so different from us that the way they exist and function is incomprehensible. What if their language is something impossible for us to achieve? All of our messages to space might be undetectable. Higher life forms might use something like telepathy and might not even be thinking or looking for outside communication. There are a lot of reasons that we might not be able to communicate at all. What if there are a lot of civilizations that are advanced, but no one is transmitting, but everyone is listening? Most of our efforts on Earth focus on listening, trying to catch these signals in space. Maybe everyone is doing the same thing. Earth sends out very little communications, as every communication is a controversy and must be vetted by worldwide councils and approved by international consultants. This sort of red tape means that very little ever gets sent out. If other civilizations are similar, everyone's listening, but no one is sending. Now, what if other advanced civilizations knew about us, but for some reason Earth is deliberately not contacted? This is based around what's called the zoo hypothesis, that Earth is known and maybe even watched, but for some reason not engaged with. It could be for entertainment, or it could be to allow our evolution to occur without incident. Maybe this whole time we've been looking and other advanced civilizations have, for some reason, chosen not to engage. Related to the zoo hypothesis is that maybe we're purposely isolated. Maybe the stars around us are fake, a simulated image that makes us think the vastness of space goes on forever, and maybe hides who is really watching us. In this case, someone would have needed to create this quote-unquote planetarium, which is kind of a cool and yet terrifying thought. We've talked about the obstacles of communication a few times, but what if civilizations were able to, but it was dangerous to communicate? For some reason, it'd either be dangerous for them, like exposing themselves to an enemy, or because they're weak against our diseases, who knows? Or maybe it'd be dangerous for us, like all of a sudden we'd be on the radar and these advanced civilizations don't want us in danger. That's nice of them, right? And now we get to another strange one. What if this world, not just the stars, was all a simulation? Our reality is designed, maybe as a game or an experiment or entertainment. The ones who created the simulation might be other humans, more technologically advanced. So if this were true, it may still mean that no contact has been made with alien life. The last two theories acknowledge that aliens are somehow here. Firstly, what if they're here undetected? They've managed to infiltrate or live among us unbeknown to us. They could be out in the open and confident, or they could exist in a form that we wouldn't notice, such as a gas or an animal life form that we would never guess was an alien. Or maybe their technology allows them to stealthily live in our world without being noticed. Or we have noticed them, but for some reason they are not acknowledged. A lot of people believe that aliens have been here, or crashed here, or abducted people from here. There are theories of government cover-ups and conspiracies. Maybe our methods of communication do work. Maybe we have made contact, but it's for some reason not spoken of. So those are the 20 reasons that might explain the Fermi paradox, how so many planets across the vastness of reality can result in zero interactions with intelligent life. If you found this interesting, give us a like and subscribe for more stuff just like this.